Now that we've had a look at the watch faces and their settings, let's also dive a bit deeper and look into the settings for the whole system in general, for which I just need to swipe down to get to airplane mode on or off, do not disturb on or off, a shortcut to set the brightness, which can go pretty bright or pretty dark. And there's also the battery display here, the data is being displayed anyways, and the settings. Settings are pretty manifold. There's the display to change the watch face again, to adjust the brightness again, to change the font size. And we could set up the always on screen, so there's not the standby screen, but the main chosen watch face is always being shown. Turning that on, of course, consumes a whole lot more battery. We find the setting for notifications here, for notification previews and how they are shown, and the do not disturb unless something. App settings are being shown here. So you can uninstall, forestop, check permissions, check the advanced, look at the app info. And you can see I have already installed quite a few apps. Also the system apps here, which dives really deep. I mean, I have honestly no idea of what most of those do, except for work for the system. There are gestures. Here, for example, my tilt to wake is turned on, so that the display turns on when I just tilt the watch. There's also wrist gestures to go back and forth through things, to check notifications, that sort of thing. There's a tutorial on it and more tips, okay. There's connectivity here, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, airplane mode, location, whether it's from the phone and the watch, so which GPS is being used, all of that. There's accessibility things, magnification gestures in there, there's personalization. Input methods, Google accounts to use, hardware buttons could be customized here, smart reply, the OK Google detection, device administration, screen lock settings, so you can set up a pin or a pattern to protect your watch even. There's also system settings here like date and time, a disconnect and reset, the restart, the power off is in here, and a lot of abouts. In date and time, for example, we get there's a notification. In date and time, we get automatic date and time. This is where I saw the sync from phone and was wondering if there was no GPS here, sync from network, so Wi-Fi basically or off. So here on the WSDF20, here you set up automatic date and time to sync from the phone, which has been working very nicely, but at least the correction of it can also be done by GPS. You can set the date, set the time also manually, get the automatic time zone, again, automatic time zone from the phone or not, not from GPS, but somehow some adjustment can be done from the GPS, though I think not the complete time zone, but maybe I just didn't see it because airports block the signal quite well. Could set the time zone manually, you can use the 24-hour format, all of that.